Guys, let's face it, no-code tools are super powerful. But sometimes we developers hesitate to use them because technically we can write the solutions ourselves. However, speaking from my own experience, I have been using no-code tools more and more lately, both for my work and managing my YouTube channel and website. Now, in this video, I'm going to share some ideas on how to connect your Streamlit app with no-code tools. This means you can use the data submitted for your Streamlit website to trigger an automation flow. For example, you could store the data in a Google Sheets or database. Then you can send out confirmation messages via email or WhatsApp and notify yourself on Slack about a new submission. The possibilities here are truly endless. So without further ado, let us dive in. Let's say you have built an entry form and you want to save the results of this entry form in a Google Sheets document. I already have tutorials on my channel about how to code this solution. However, in this tutorial, I will use a no-code tool to do the job for me. So, in the end, I will have a website form, and when I press the submit button, the data will be saved to my Google Sheets. The process is pretty straightforward. Let me walk you through it. First of all, I have my form, which includes fields for a name, email, and a video idea. Below that, there's a submit button. When that button is triggered, I store the submitted data in a dictionary. And here's the trick. I take that data and send out a post request to a webhook URL. Currently, I haven't set up the webhook URL, so that is why I get this error. Before we go any further, let me briefly explain what a webhook actually is. Think of a webhook like a doorbell for servers. When something important happens on one server, the webhook sends a quick message to another server to let it know about the event. It's a way for servers to talk to each other automatically. So that means if somebody submits a form, I want to inform another server about it. Now, you could set up your own server or write your own webhook handler in Python, but we will use a no-code tool for that. There are many no-code automation tools available like Zapier, make.com or Pabbly. I personally use Pabbly, but they all work pretty similar. If you want to follow along, you can sign up for Pabbly for free. Out of the box, you get 100 free monthly tasks, which might be already enough for your use case. Once logged in, I will create a new workflow and give it a name. The idea of such automation tools is always the same. First, you need to define what will trigger the automation flow. That could be, for example, a message on Discord, a new YouTube video that has been published, or, like in our case, we will go with the webhook. So let me select webhook here from the list. Next, Pabbly will generate a webhook URL for you. We now want to use that URL in our Streamlit app. So let me copy it to my clipboard, go back to my code, and paste it here. Okay, with that in place, I can now return to my website and submit the data again. Now we are sending that data to our webhook. Back in Pabbly, we will now see that we have received the following data. Alright, and now you can basically do whatever you want with it. You could, for example, save the data in Airtable, send out a confirmation email, or send ourselves a message in Slack or Discord. In our case, I will simply save the entry to Google Sheets. So in the next step, let me search for Google Sheets. Next, you can choose what actions inside Google Sheets you want to take. In my case, I want to add a new row. To do so, click on Connect. If you are using Pabbly and Google Sheets for the first time, you first need to set up a new connection to your Google account. However, I have done that already, so I will use my existing connection. Next, I need to specify the spreadsheet and worksheet name. In my case, I have prepared a spreadsheet already, which is pretty simple. Here I just inputted the headers. Okay, next up, we just need to map the data. So in the name column, I want to write the data we have received from the webhook. And I will do the same for email and the suggestion fields. And that's pretty much it. Next, let me save and send a test request. Once that is done, I can check the results in my Google Sheet. And as we can see, the data has been successfully stored. Alright, so as I said, feel free to add any other step. You could, for example, connect it to your Gmail account and send out an email. However, in my case, I will really keep it simple here. So let me delete this step and just go back to my dashboard. And to test things out one more time, I will change the data and submit another form. And if I now go back to my spreadsheet, we will see the new entry. Alright guys, and this is how easy it is to connect your Streamlit app with no-code automation tools. Also, please feel free to use this website to send me your ideas for future video topics. The link to the live website will be in the description below. Okay, and with that said, thanks for watching and I will see you in the next video.